I would like to tire you with figures and numbers, unlike my other two friends and colleagues, because I love numbers and figures, and also because I have a feeling that lately what's been happening in Israel is less hatred for the rich, but hatred of facts, and especially hatred of figures. So we tend to build upside-down pyramids where there is very little facts and lots of interpretations and commentaries up on top. And these are the upside-down pyramids, which I think are even more dangerous than the regular pyramids. And the classic question is, what really happened to the security expenses in over the last 5 or 10 years? Well, according to the Bank of Israel report and all the findings and data that I quote is according to the report by the Bank of Israel that was published just a little under a month ago, the cost of security locally have gone down over the last decade from something like 6.5% of a GNP, a GDP to 5%, and that is a very considerable drop, because 1.5%, I have to say, even if I disagree with you, but I don't think that security wins at the end always, because I think that no such drop, no such parallel drop has been seen in any other section of the budget, especially not in the civil section of the budget. And there has also been a drop between 1.8% to 1% in the expenses outside the country. So we are seeing a significant drop from 8.5% to just over 7% of the GDP, and a little more than 6% of the GDP in just a short period of time, just one decade. And you all know better than I do that this decade has had quite a few defense and security incidents that have been very expensive, and they were very complex, at least I think so. And what does this calculation entail? This is by the Statistical Bureau of Israel and the Bank of Israel. How can we crack the numbers? Well, first of all, we're talking about defense consumption. This is everything that the defense system is paying for is consumption, except for several amounts that I will talk about in a minute. So if the defense system has been asked to build a barrier up north or down south, this is not an investment. This is classified according to the various parameters that were set and determined after World War II. All security expenses are considered consumption. Then nothing is regarded as investment. On the other hand, you should all remember that these expenses do not include two sections that are part of the budget. One is pensions, and the other is various memorial sites, etc., and commemoration. And this has a lot of weight because these are the main payments, transfer payments to the taxpayers are transferring these funds to the other sectors of society, and this means they are getting no reward for this. So this is a lose-lose situation. So in the Bank of Israel report and another report, we see a column that includes all the expenses, all the pensions given out to people from the defense system, and the commemoration expenses, and it's something like 0.7 or 0.9% of the budget. So this year, it's very easy to see, because the GDP in Israel this year will, God willing, be about 1,000 billion shekels. So 1% is 10 million, and that is very easy to remember. As we said, the expenses for pensions are not regarded as defense expenses, and I can give you an example for why it is. For instance, the Ministry of Transportation's budget does not include the pensions of its workers. It is part of an overall expense of the government system, and the same is true for expenses that have to do with the health system. Again, doctors who work in hospitals and government hospitals, their pensions are an integral part of the transfer payments made by the government as a government. And as for the commemoration expenses and memorial site expenses, well, I believe that some of it should have been attributed to the national insurance budget. Pension, in terms of the Israeli government and in terms of the national economy, a pension in the defense system. These are, in fact, delayed expenses. They were taken, they were spent in the past, but we are paying for them now. And that is why the Statistical Bureau of Statistics in Israel, the way they do things should be the way to go, and it should be really seen as a transfer payment. Now, what happened over these last 5 years that I'm talking about? Because it's very interesting, I think, to look at the macroeconomic calculation as well. We said before that we are missing 30 billion shekel, or we have a deficit of 30 billion shekel, and this deficit really will be 30 billion shekel, because 3% of GDP are 30 billion shekel. It will be even higher than 30 billion shekel. But these billions are should be looked at, maybe with reservation, because we have to remember these we're a large country, we have a large economy, we have $1,000 billion. Again, the word billion still gives us the shivers, but in terms of the national budget, we're talking about small change. So what happened in Why is it that in 2007, the State of Israel and the Israeli government, in the largest sense of the word, which includes all the national institutions, the Jewish agency, the local authorities, and so forth, how come there was no deficit then? And last year, we have a 4.5% GDP deficit. So it's a little less, but let's say it's 4.5%. So who is to blame for creating this deficit of 4.5% of the GDP? Well, the civil consumption, or its weight, has gone up by 0.5%. So the civil consumption of the public and the government have not been harnessed. And as we said, the defense expenses have gone down. So not only did they not contribute to the deficit, they have actually stopped it from being even worse. And the cost of interest, which also has to do with security, but again, their weight has gone down by almost 1.5%. And also the cost of interest, they did not contribute to the deficit. In fact, they made sure it wasn't even worse. So what created the deficit? Well, a policy by the Prime Minister and the Minister of Finance to benefit people by lowering taxes. Taxes has gone down by 4.5%, and that is what created the deficit that Israel now has to deal with. It wasn't security, which would have contributed if it were the only contributing factor, the deficit would have gone down. And it wasn't even the interest that paid overseas for defense purposes. It was mostly or almost entirely just the lowering of taxes. And when you lower taxes, and this just so you know, it has nothing to do with what we're saying here, but it must be said that when you lower taxes, Israel is now at a point where the weight of tax in the GDP is the lowest in the West by far, lower than any other country, and that has created a hole of 30 to 35 billion shekels in taxes. If we had paid taxes today the same way we had paid in 2007, we would have had 35 billion shekels more in income for Israel. And that is why the government was forced to minimize or to keep a very low level of civil public expenditure, so that at the end of the day, when we are now the country with the lowest expenditure for civil public issues. So that is why we are feeling this crunch on the security budget. And I don't think that I can say anything about what should be done. Amos knows this better than me, what should be done with the defense budget or shouldn't be done with the defense budget. But in terms of a macroeconomic perspective, I do not see a situation whereby the local defense budget of Israel, as defined by the Bank of Israel and the Bureau of Statistics, can go down significantly below the 4.5% of GDP. We are now at 5% GDP, and I think it is plausible to talk about the weight going down by about 4.5% GDP. That is also the goal set by the Brodet Committee in its multi-annual analysis. In 5 years, they wanted the GDP, the to go down so that it goes it becomes 5%. So now I think we can only talk about 4.5%. We can reach this goal, and I think this is what the government is aiming to do, especially by freezing the defense expenses, making them remain at this level, and to have a growth by 3 or 3.5% in GDP. Then within a short period of time, relatively, we will indeed get to another drop of the weight of the defense expenses. But again, this should be the macroeconomic goal. I think the discussion should center around. I don't want to allow myself to talk about some sort of battle, a dramatic war. I again have to say that macroeconomically speaking, most of the repair of the correction is already behind the defense industry, because a 1.5% drop is very significant by any measurement, and I think that most of the correction really is behind the defense system. Now all that is left is to go down by that one, that 0.5%. I know that also when you are in a race, and also in the Eurovision contest, song contest, and the end is always the hardest, but this is not something that I, as a civilian, and also a little bit as an economist, is really too hard. So thank you very much.